Well, we had a mass dancing class here. There must have been 100 people in there. And they were doing it like drill formation, you know, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And at 10 to 11, 5 to 11, I went back to my switch room and I put the tannoy on, the loudspeaker. Yeah. I cut their music off. And then we had the Big Ben, crash, bang, bollock, you know. And Neville Chamberlain came in, state of war exists.
We couldn't close when the bombs were on, we had to keep open.
I was elected to go onto the roof and decide, I had to make the decision, whether it was safe for the people to carry on dancing or not. Well, when you realise that Jerry was flying over, and if he dropped the bomb at Barking, 12 miles away, that could hit the Palais, it was putting a lot on my shoulders to decide whether it was safe for them to stay there, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So I made an arrangement with the band leader, at the time was Oscar Raven, he disappeared, and then we had Harry Leader. And if I come down and flash the torch, they go potty. They start playing Woodchopper's Ball and anything with noise. The drummer used to work overtime, crashing and cymbal, you know. They tried to kill any noise outside, and I used to have to decide whether it was safe. But, I mean, whether they expected me to catch a bomb in my tin hat and throw it over the side, I don't know. But never once did I say it wasn't safe, because I knew it was ridiculous to say it wasn't safe. I was going to be in fright, if my number was on it, I would have got it. That's how I used to look at it.
My husband was a prisoner of war, so the only consolation I had was to come dancing, which I did. And I had several partners only for dancing, and it was lovely. And we went in for many competitions, and the last one was June the 6th, 1945, when I had a phone message here from my sister to say my husband had arrived back from Germany. So I said goodbye to my partner, and away I went. And I just won a big competition.